One of the important uses of streamflow data is to assess the availability of surface water in a river basin. Streamflow data are also used for flood forecasting or flood warning. We use the data to help design hydraulic structures such as bridges or to delineate floodplains. Scientists use the data to help understand the ecological needs of rivers and water bodies. Even recreational users depend upon streamflow data to understand the conditions on the river.
Continuous streamflow monitoring is the practice of collecting streamflow data or streamflow measurements at a very constant interval, roughly every 15 minutes or less. So that gives us a full record of the streamflow that's passed a given point in the river over a long period of time. So it lets us collect records of total flow over a day, a week, a month, a year.
USGS treats streamflow information as if it's the pulse of our ecosystem. We're collecting long-term data at many, many sites that we can use. We focus on collecting the most accurate and up-to-date streamflow information at many sites that we can.
Typical streamflow gauging station includes instruments to measure the water level. It could be a pressure transducer, it could be a float in a stilling well that moves up and down as the river changes levels. It could be an acoustic radar device measured or mounted under a bridge. To measure streamflow discharge, the cubic feet per second that's flowing by the river, then we need to go out and we actually measure the depth of the river and the velocity of the river at intervals along a cross-section. So that means that to operate a gauging station, we have to continually go out and make these periodic measurements of discharge.
The cost of installing, operating, and maintaining continuous monitoring stations applies everywhere. In remote areas or areas where they have really flashy streams, streams that go dry for part of the year and then have high flows during a flood season or during a monsoon season, those can be some of the toughest and the most expensive.
We have to send our people out on very long trips, and it can be quite costly because a lot of the times it requires complicated transportation, including helicopters, and or long hikes, even with type of pack animals in some cases. So to have systems set up at sites like this that can accurately measure streamflow without the need to have as much human interaction would significantly lower the cost of those two particular instances.
Many types of waterways could benefit from lower cost solutions of continuous streamflow monitoring. Streams that experience moving silt beds or sand beds, aquatic vegetation, or ephemeral inflows are all challenging environments to gauge.
What we really need to focus on with this prize competition is reducing the cost. We want to maintain the accuracy, we want to maintain the reliability, but we need to reduce the cost.
Where I see innovation for this competition is somebody being able to integrate multiple types of approaches at one particular gauge for the same kind of cost.
Some stations have records of over 100 years. So when you lose a gauging station, you're not just losing the information at a particular location, but you're losing part of a network.
It's exciting that USGS and the Bureau of Reclamation are partnering on this project, because at USGS, we strive to collect the best, most accurate, and largest streamflow network of data in the country. And the Bureau of Reclamation, for the vast majority of the projects that they manage, requires accurate real-time streamflow information.
The better and cheaper our streamflow monitoring is, the better data we have to work with to plan and manage our water resources systems, to predict and react to flood events and drought events, and to manage our water resources more efficiently. So we're hoping that folks who are out there from other fields with other interests are going to be able to take their ideas and apply it to our problem and come up with new solutions that help us reduce the cost of continuous streamflow monitoring.